Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video. Next match, Cross Banlist Cup. Second match here in the Cross Banlist Cup 2016 and the top 16, two very big decks. First of all, the first place here, Clownblade. OCG Clownblade, definitely a title candidate due to the huge, huge extra deck and powerful exceed plays the deck has. Second deck, we already know, which is a Dragon Ruler variant here. The Dragon Ruler is still in this tournament. The Light Swan Ruler variant, definitely very powerful, especially with Soul Charge, for example. But let's not waste any more time. Let's hop into the first game. Alright, first duel, and I think my opponent gets to start. Yeah, the opponent is playing with Light Swan Rulers. I am playing with the Clownblade deck, since it's extremely fun. He gets to start, and we know, I believe, Soul Charge is at 3 in the deck. Although he decides to go... Leo is an excellent choice, but I think I have two very easy outs in the form of Utopia the Lightning and Exciton. Exciton Knight is still legal, at least for this deck. And it also goes for Lava Wall Chain to set up those double Eclipse, you know, and Redox as well, which is all okay. But I believe a minor mistake on his part is not setting up the double JD and the Light Ray monster in his hand. So not enough lights in his grave, and that's going to hurt him, especially after this huge Exciton blowout. That's the reason why Exciton Knight, Exciton Knight is banned in the TCG, but still sadly not really sure about why it's still legal in the OCG. But anyway, and with Ice Field, Lava Wall Chain still in the deck here to set up the Clownblade engine and Ptolemaios as well to have the threat of Pleiades during my opponent's turn. And then, yeah, if Ptolemaios isn't needed, I can just go for an Infinity during my own turn. But again, the Blade is coming through, and here is where the lack of light monsters hurts him a lot. No double JD and no Rainbow Kuribor or something like that, so I can freely attack for game. So a minor mistake, but he's going to make up for that here in the second game. Second game, he gets a start, he has the advantage, and must be nice, right? Remember the time you played like a Light Sworn deck and milled off of your charge like double Eclipse and the Minerva? Yeah, I also remember that. It never happened. It never happened to me. Anyway, again, the Soul Charge, it's such a disgusting card for like 3, I believe, and indeed, now he's setting up all those light monsters in his grave, and I think we know his hand. Yeah, indeed, double JD and 2 unknown cards. I decided to attack over the Lila, I believe. Yeah, because I wanted to main phase 2 Reborn for Lila, pop his back row, and safely go for Exciton. Safely go for Exciton, but reveals one of the Rainbow Kuribos. So no Exciton rip eventually due to the effect negation of Breakthrough Skill. Lava Wall Chain can set up a possible Infinity, but... yeah, Infinity is not too strong in this case. I mean, we know he has double JD in hand. Not negating the blast here wouldn't really make much sense, I believe. And also because of the Breakthrough Skill in his grave. Breakthrough Skill is excellent against this Clownblade deck, especially because of Cyber Dragon Infinity, for example. And now he's free to attack for game. So game number 3. But as always, I have the advantage to start. And the Empowered Field spell, which hopefully might come soon to the TCG, I can make a first turn. Lava Wall Chain again, setting up the Clownblade engine of 1000 blades. And Trick Clown. And go for the huge threat, which is Shock Moss. And this was a no-brainer due to like a trap card, like Breakthrough Skill or Warning. I can negate any monster effect or prevent my opponent from having a monster on the field, so I call spells with Shock Monster. So no Solar Recharge, no charge, prevent him from setting up his grave, and immediately during my own turn call traps, so no Wing Blast. At least, yeah, if he would have had Wing Blast or Breakthrough Skill, he already would have activated that in the if it indeed was a Wing Blast. But no Wing Blast, so only out here is the Rainbow Kuribo, and he doesn't have it. So Clownblade takes this win and moves on to the top 8. So second deck here in the top 8 is known. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video.